Stargate effect from 2001 A Space Odyssey, directed by Stanley Kubrick, while the effect was created by Douglas Trumbull. Here's how the first shot looks like. This is a remake attempt. Does it look similar? Up to you to judge. What is nice about this effect though is that it is very experimental, allowing you to get all sorts of crazy shapes drawn mostly by just using the shader editor. We are going to do just that. Let's start from the base setup. Destroy the cube and light. We will use EV renderer, fast render times. Put camera in the middle, X rotation 90, Y, Z, 0. Set focal length to 70 mm. That's what Stanley Kubrick used. Mesh creation. Create a plane, rotate Y 90 degrees, scale 13X, Y 50, location Y 45, entire thing should be in view. Move it to the side a bit, X by minus 1.3, duplicate the plane. Rotate the duplicated part by X 180, put the second plane on the plus X 1.3. Select both planes and join them. Enter edit mode. Merge plane to one at the horizon vertices. Merge should be at the center. UVs. We don't want repeating textures. Select one face and enter UV editing workspace. Grab the face and move it away. A bit. Mine is at X 0.6 and Y at 2.3. This will reduce the mirrored feeling. Scale face by Y minus 1. Now both face UVs will move to the same direction when this is animated. Setup for shaders. This is where fun mistakes turn into features. Enter shading workspace. Enter render to. Create a new material. Principled BSDF is too complex for our needs. Change it to emission instead. My approach will be combined shapes. We want some colorful stars, random straight lines, some curves. Stars! Create a Voronoi texture. Type is 2D. Smooth F1. Euclidean. Scale high. 350. Add color ramp node. Plug Voronoi color to factorial. Compared with distance, shapes will be more round. Ramp up black to like 0.96. Use stars with our UV map. Node wrangle mapping and coordinates nodes. Change coordinates to UV instead of generated. Colors. We want some pretty colors. Add noise node. Set 2D. We see this sort of noise. Scale 1. Detail 3.7. Roughness 1. Plug our vector node to vector noise input. Add color ramp node. Go wild with the colors. Add mix node, change mode to screen, put your star shape into factor. Change A to black, it's dark and empty now, just like space. Put your star color into B input. This will fill in the empty void. Let's see what we currently have by plugging the mix node into emission and emission into surface output. I'll frame the star pattern noise with color ramp, naming it star pattern. We'll keep things organized. We can start our effect movement. Expand timeline panel, select mapping node and insert keyframe to location at frame 0. I'll go to frame 500 and will change Y to 14 meters. This should give a decent amount of speed. Note that speed is not linear, default is bezier. To change to linear, select all your keyframes, then press V, then change mode to vector. Now our stars move at constant speed. Lines. So the lines and also the waves afterwards follow a similar approach. The magic is in the noise, and for lines the fitting noise will be Voronoi. Edit and change time to Chebyshev. God knows how to pronounce this. Change scale to 30. Randomness to maybe 0.5. Add color ramp node and plug distance into factorial. Distance in Voronoi texture gives a grayscale representation of locations from one cell to another. Squeeze the black ramp value to 0.6 and white to 0.67. Connect animated mapping node. Copy both nodes for some additional variety. Animated mapping to new noise vector. Change second noise scale to around 80 and randomness to 0.1 to make them a bit thinner. Loosen the ramp black to around 0.535 and white to around 0.75. With a math node, add both values. Frame your noises up to add node included and call it lines. Extras. We can split these lines even further for detail. Add wave texture this time. Change scale to 70. A subtle amount of distortion. One is okay. Plug our vector mapping node for moving animation. Color ramp node for noise. Color or factorial as input is good. Put black to around 0.3 for wider gaps. Now the splitting of existing lines is done with adding math node and multiplying our remapped Voronoi textures.
Cool, I'll frame Voronoi texture with ramp and we'll name it divided lines. Time to color the lines. Copy the setup we had with stars. Make sure vector mapping animation is connected again. I'll change up the noise and color ramp a bit to differ from star ranges. Starting with using factorial as input instead of color for clarity. Easier to understand the results when it's shown in grayscale. Changing random values now. Scale 0.5, detail 2.2, and reducing red color dominance. My aim is to have mostly purple color with occasional glimpses of other colors. Plug lines, multiply the result to mix factorial. Copy the mix node, but this time input our line mix result to A and stars mix input to B. Stars and line results should be combined now. All those vector mapping animation nodes are getting a bit messy. Let's create extra noodle connections by holding right mouse button and left shift. Curves. This is a funky and very experimental one. Start off with a wave texture. Use triangle. This will give our curves pointy ends later. Scale 1. Repetition will be quite noticeable with higher values. Distortion 5. Phase offset 3. This will be important to emerge lines more at center for higher impact. Connect vector mapping to wave texture vector. Now the fun distortion part. Copy the wave texture. Create a new vector mapping node, connect the animated mapping node to currently created mapping node vector and connect the new mapping to the vector of new wave texture. Let's play with the copied wave texture parameters. Change axis to Y, distortion to 1, detail scale to around 52.6. Now connect previous wave texture to location. Notice how our first wave texture is distorted along the new wave texture. It's the look I'm going for. For sharpness, add mix node. Put first wave texture to A input, put second wave texture to B. Add math node and change mode to compare. Value 1.4, epsilon 0.425. A cut must be clear instead of being noise on the whole screen. Your needs may be different. Now we see impulsive arrow shooting. New mix node again, factor 0.6, compare to A, previous mix to B. Color ramp it, blacked around 0.5. Arrows should be bigger now. It's a bit too arrowy, needs more noise. Add a Voronoi texture, connect animated mapping output to Voronoi vector input, change noise type to smooth F1, distance metric to Chebyshev, scale to around 131.7, smoothness to 0.66. Add another color ramp and plug Voronoi distance to it. Set black to 0.5 again. Create mapping node and plug it in between second wave texture and mix node. Now connect your Voronoi color ramp to location. You should now have small chaotic points scattered around the arrows. Bit more small details. I want the arrow animation repositioned a bit so curves would have bigger impact coming towards you. Add mapping node, plug it before first wave texture. Set location X to 2, Y to -0.9. Lengthen the arrows, add another mapping node and plug it before the mapping node of the second wave texture. Scale Y to 0.5. Perfection! Frame all your curve nodes and I'll name them waves. Now time for wave colors. Add two noise nodes, Y2. One noise will be small scale value so the color would vary over time, while the other one will be the common noise result with a large scale value. Set both noises to smooth F1. Set first scale to 0.5. Connect your animated mapping node to both noises. Mix both textures. Copy color ramp from either lines or star setups and slightly alter ranges of your palette. Add mix color node. Wave noise is factor input. Make sure mode is screen. A is black, B is wave color ramp. Add mix node again. Plug our wave screen mix to A. Plug our stars and lines final mix to B. I would also like to reduce the intensity of waves so it would show less dominance over lines and stars. Add the hue saturation value node between wave mix color and mix color screen nodes, then change the value to 0.1. I think it's also a good time to change main emission value to 100. Our effect should be very bright. I'll also tweak and clean the noodles and nose a bit. Emerging effects. Scene setup. We need some glow at the whole setup. Enable bloom. I'll use the following settings. Threshold 0, knee 1.0, radius 3.5, intensity 0.02, clamp 0. In color management, change look to very low contrast and exposure to 1. Reduced contrast will help to get the old school washed out footage look. You may have gray areas at top and bottom. Space is black and empty. Go to world and change background color to pure 0. Embrace the void. I have mine already changed. Mask. We will extend post-processing effects further later, but before that, if you look at the first Stargate shot in the movie, you will notice that various effects gradually emerge. So we should do the same with our stars, lines, and waves. I like to emerge each element from the center and expand from there. For this, we will need to create a mask. To create a mask, start with two gradient textures. Invert the first gradient texture with color ramp, move black to 1, move white to 0. Add math multiply, color ramp to first input, second gradient texture to second input. We see the darkest gradient areas cancel out the brightest ones of each gradient. Okay, that's a symmetrical gradient. The shape that we are going for to get a gradual emerge effect is a triangle though. We can rotate the gradients to achieve this. Add mapping nodes before each gradient. These will be our triangle angle nodes. Set the Z angle on the first node to 45. Set the Z angle on the second node to minus 45. Add another mapping node, connect to vector outputs to inputs of our angle mapping nodes. Y location will be our offset controller. We don't see anything yet since we don't specify texture coordinates. Create texture coordinates node. We can use either generated or UV again. Generated will create an even mask on both sides since the texture UVs will be generated from the bounding box of our planes. I'll use this method for stars and lines. UVs will emerge one side faster than the other. This will give some variation for a wave pattern, so we'll go with that later. The triangle is not in the middle. X to 0.3 in the first node should do it. We can play with the location Y parameter of our first mapping node. The expansion may need to be slower. Setting scale Y to 0.1 will help. Now pointy end of triangle front is a bit dim. This will fade our effects and may not be desired. Add color ramp node, put Y to some crazy value like 0.000001. Let's actually use the mask now against our stars. Move the generated texture coordinates away next to our UV texture coordinate. Copy the animated mapping node that was connected to UV texture coordinate. Connect the generated coordinate to vector of copied mapping node. You may notice that copied mapping node does not retain the animation. I'm not sure why this behavior is like this, so let's quickly recreate the animation. In timeline, make sure you are at frame 0. In location Y of the node, set keyframe as 0 value. Go to frame 500, set location Y as 14. Select both keyframes, press V, vector. Animation is linear again. Connect the generated coordinates animated mapping node to vector input of mask mapping node. Set Y location of mask mapping node to minus 0.6. When you start out the animation, you should now see the mask emerge right from the start. Frame nodes from offset mapping to very white color ramp. Name the group Emerge Stars. The last and most important steps, combine the stars with mask. Create a math node, set to multiply. Value number 1 is the output of our star pattern. Value number 2 is the output of our mask. Replace the factor of color mix node where star pattern input was plugged with the output of multiply node. If we now preview just the color mix node, we can see how stars don't just immediately appear but gradually come in. Perfect. Lines and curves are left. Lines mask. Copy emerge dot setup. Clean up the nodes a bit to give some space. Move it below lines. Rename frame to emerge lines. Connect vector generated coordinates. I'd say keyframe 150 is the point where it gets boring to look at only the stars. Set Y to minus 1 to position 150th frame as line mask emerge point. Add math multiply node. Put it between lines multiply and mix node. Multiply lines output to 1 multiply input and emerge lines mask output to another. Preview mix node between mixing lines and stars. Let's see what we have. We can make the mask a bit fancier too to make the shape less uniform. Add noise texture, type 2D, connect noise with generated vector, scale to 35.8, detail 6.5, roughness 0.65. Add color ramp node, set black to 0.5. Add color mix to blend the noise with mask in some fancy way. Lines mask color ramp output to input B. Put the mask noise to input A. Color burn gives quite a nice effect. The cutoff is too sharp. Adjust the color ramp white value of main lines mask to 0.001 instead. Connect mix to multiply instead of mask ramp. Waves mask, last shader touches. Copy the merge dots mask setup again. Reorganize the nodes a bit. Put it below wave setup. Rename it to emerge waves. I would like my waves to pop out from one side first and also before the lines. For this, I will connect UV vector node instead of generated coordinates. Set waves mask vector y offset to around -0.92. This will emerge the wave around frame 55. Add math multiply between waves color ramp output and screen mix node. Multiply waves and waves mask. There is a bit of a seam in the beginning where the wave emerges, not very noticeable, but we can wash it out a bit by reducing color ramp white from the crazy 0.000 value to 0.1. Okay, masks are done. Let's enjoy some compositing. Compositing. First of all, let's listen how Douglas Trumbull achieved the effect. A bit late, but it's relevant.
I had been exposed to some things like time-lapse photography and what is called streak photography. Now, if you can imagine that you're out at night shooting moving cars with your camera on a tripod and you open the shutter for 10 seconds, a headlight becomes a bar of light, called a streak exposure or a blur.
We can mimic the exposure time with motion blur a little bit, do a render and observe the difference. Since our pattern is already abstract and the leaks are faked, we do not want to crank the samples to insane amounts, default settings will do just fine. Open compositing window, select use node. You will get render layers and your final output, composite node. Note preview shortcut is same as with shaders menu. Control shift left click. Let's define what effects we want, which will be vignette, lens distortion, more washed out glow. For the fun of it, I'll also add some expanding glow right at the end of our animation. Vignette, add ellipse mask to define the shape of darkened edges. We want corners darkened the most. X and Y 0.5 with width set to 0.6 and height to 0.3 should be decent. Something where mask covers half of the screen. Add blur node, connect mask to image. Check relative to have size uniform in case we switch resolution. X and Y to 50%. Add alpha over node. Blur output to factorial. Add render image to second input image. Set first input black. Now the dark mask areas will affect the output. That's our vignette. For lens distortion, just add lens distortion node after vignette output. Distort to 0.04 and dispersion to 0.2 should work nicely. We now have some chromatic aberration effects happening, especially at the edges of the screen. For more washed glow, add glare node. I'll play with the values. Fog glow low, threshold at 0.1 should be fine. Let's add some glow in the middle at the end of animation to spice the effect up a bit. Add box mask, set width very narrow, 0.001 will do the trick. Make sure height covers the whole height of the screen. 0.58 should do it. Blur it a lot with blur node. Change mode to fast Gaussian. It appears to give a wider falloff compared with regular Gaussian. Tick relative, set X to 1%. Add normalize node to map the gradient between 0 to 1 range. Add math node, plug our alpha over output, the vignette result, change to multiply. Multiply by 10,000 for some extreme glow. Add math node again, change to multiply, plug normalized middle box mask, plug our multiplied glow. Observe that we now have middle glow effect, we just need to combine it with render output. Add mix node, plug the multiplied output, change mode to color, plug the alpha over vignette result, we now have colored middle glow. Add another mix node, plug the previous color mix node, plug the alpha over vignette output, squeeze it between lens distortion. Now animate the glow. In your mix node, at frame 200, insert keyframe at value 1, go to frame 300, change value to 0.5. Insert keyframe again. Render your animation and that's it. Cheers!
Bonus effects. Here's a couple more similar tries you can download and check out. Simple Stargate attempt number 1. Simple Stargate attempt number 2. Apple WWDC 223 watch effect. Here's the original. Here's a similar recreation driven by images as scrolling textures. A lot more post-processing and spinning is needed to make this convincing, but hey, an attempt was made. What's nice with this one is that it requires minimum amount of dealing with shader node.